I want to bring up to say a few words, the former Olympic gold medalist, one of the best fighters in the world at 140 pounds. And his strength and conditioning coach, Alex Arisa, will be kind enough to do the translation for us. So Felix Diaz and Alex Arisa.
Buenas tardes a todos. Primeramente quiero darle las gracias a Dios, al Team Craft, porque que me ha dado la oportunidad. Mi equipo de trabajo que lo consiguió, José Núñez, Ay Helmer, Ludy Vela. Y nada, esperando que lo que viene para el 20 de mayo sea algo grande, lo que es poderme coronar campeón mundial.
First, I want to thank God. I want to thank Team Crawford for giving us the opportunity to take on such a big fight. I want to thank Lou DiBella, Al Haymon, HBO. On the 20th, it's going to be an incredible opportunity for him.
Como diría, vengo de pelear con los grandes. Cuando firmé con mi manager José Núñez, le dije que quería pelear con los mejores. Estoy peleando con los mejores. Es el Crawford, es uno de los mejores boxeadores en estos momentos y me siento muy bien por con quien voy a pelear en estos momentos.
When I was arguing with my managers about getting fighting the biggest fights out there, Crawford was number one since he's the best out there, and it's such an amazing opportunity to finally get that fight with him.
Y nada, esperando el apoyo de todo mi pueblo dominicano el 20 de mayo.
And especially want to thank all the support that I'm going to get from all the people from the Dominican Republic that's going to be here on the 20th of May. And we'll wait to see everybody there. Thank you.
You know, one of the great things is when you're at a press conference and it's your turn to introduce your fighter or the guy that you're associated with, it's easy to, you start to reflect, how did you get here? And honestly, I can tell you, the truth is, one of the harder things to do is to not start with somebody from the beginning, but to inherit them a little bit into their careers. We've had a really good success of taking guys from the pro debut all the way through. And in terms of situation, that wasn't the case. We took him on a little later when he had a couple fights under his belt. And this meteoric rise came down to one thing. He's a fighter. And little opportunities came up. Never forget, we were in Las Vegas and there was an opportunity for him to fight Prescott, who had knocked out Amir Khan. And everyone says, this guy's a beast. He's a tough right-handed puncher. And Cameron Duncan was quiet. Brian McIntyre was like, hell, let's do it. So was Terrence. Boom, there we go. Next big opportunity, a fighter turns down a fight with Gamboa. The door opens, Terrence walks through it, and here we go. Omaha, Nebraska, 10,000 people, and he took that opportunity. So, this example is an example that we wish I could get in prize fighting. It is called prize fighting because when you take the risk, you get the prize. The prize is you're filling the garden. You're coming.